Today we're going to be talking about deck lighting, and specifically I want to talk to you about how inviting and how much warmth that adding deck lighting can create in a backyard. A deck can become kind of a cold place after the sun goes down, but when you add the lighting, there creates such an ambiance, and it's so inviting into the late hours of the night for people and friends and family together. So let me get started with you and talk specifically about how to get these small lights into your deck. Now, one of the best times to do this is at the point where a deck is being newly built, or perhaps it's being remodeled and you're taking down all of the railings. This gives you an opportunity to install the lights in a really clean way, because you want to make sure that you're hiding a lot of the wires, that you don't want to draw too much attention to where everything is connected, and you want to draw more attention to the light itself. Now, this particular system used to be a halogen system, and the bulbs, the lamps in here were actually halogen, and they drew a lot of power. And when you would walk up, and there's a dome right here, there's a piece of glass like a housing in front of the lamp itself. If this were halogen, when you put your finger on it, it would literally burn the skin off of your fingers. It gets so hot. But due to all the advances in LED technology, these types of lights that use a little bi-pin lamp in it are able to be retrofitted with an LED lamp. So when you walk up to it, it's no more than just slightly warm to the touch. This circular light has all these wires are running up underneath this 2x6. So in a new application, what you do is you come in and you route a groove. Same thing that happens with a retrofit application, with the exception of in a retrofit application, it would actually cost more money to install the lighting system, because you have to take the time and energy to pull off this this top rail. You turn it upside down and you route a groove right down the center of this on the bottom side. And within that groove is where that lighting, that low voltage lighting wire will run. Now let's take a look up here at the rest of this deck area. And you know, I've tried showing these pictures at night. Honestly, when you film this and you do it at night, it does not do all of the justice that it does seeing it in person. Because on a camera, the lights just kind of tend to show up really bright. You don't get that really nice amber look that you're seeing when you're seeing it in person. So let's take a look. So each one of these posts has one of these lights built into it. And one thing that I want to point out specifically on these lights is this. This has, and a lot of lights work the same way. That's why I'm showing it to you like this. There's so many different lighting options. Some can get tucked up underneath this railing. There's LED strips that you can use, which are not my favorite to use on decks. Even though they look great, the LED strips almost put out a little too much light because they go continuously around it, and it can kind of look like a landing strip. That's why I like these to have to be mounted right up here in the post. So one of the things that I'll point out is where you have this housing, let me get out of the dog's way there, where you have this housing, let's look at it over here. If you do not screw this housing in using a, drill or an impact wrench, because if you do it, it's going to put too much pressure, and I have cracked many of these glass globes that go around the lamp by using too much pressure on a screwdriver or using an impact wrench. So I always use a hand screwdriver to tighten these down just snug. And you'll notice in this deck, here's one of the wires coming right down the side of this deck area right here. Let me show that to you. So there's one of the wires. We've got it tucked away really nicely at the house. You're going to have to tuck this wire in at a couple different places, and you want to do it in the most concealed, inconspicuous area as possible, because the rest of the installation is so clean. So this wire routes up right underneath this 2x6 into the post, and then the wires where they come out in front are able to be connected and tucked back into the post. So you don't really ever see any of this. I have seen lighting jobs where people will come from the outside of the post, and you look at the outside of the deck, and there's all kinds of wires running up underneath here and dangling out, and you just look and the job is not clean. It's a little bit ugly. So when we do these jobs, we want to try to keep these wires as inconspicuous, as hidden as absolutely possible. So in this particular deck, there's only two locations. There's one wire over here and one that I showed you just a couple of minutes ago. So in a retrofit application, you're going to have more cost invested in a per light or per fixture cost than you would say in a outdoor front yard lighting application. When you're doing it outside for the front of a house, all you have to do is simply drill into the ground, put your light and your stake in the ground, wire it up, and put the wires in a trench. Here it's a lot more work. I mean, you're going to need some carpentry skills, or you're going to need to have a carpenter that knows what they're doing, and if you're subbing that out, that can add to the cost of it. So you're really better off learning how to do this small amount of carpentry work yourself. Most of it is involved in routing this groove into this 2x6. I recommend doing it with a router. It can be done with a circular saw, but it's going to create a really long cut with that circular saw. You're going to be adjusting your depth gauge on that saw and making multiple passes in order to route that groove out. That's going to take a long time. You can do it on a table saw with a stacked dado head cutter. That's also going to take a long time. Really, the router is the best tool for this. If you've never used a router, don't be afraid of it. I mean, I just get a piece of plywood and practice with it. They're really not all that hard to use, and you can get a narrow half inch or 5/8 inch flat bottom cutting bit, that's the word that I'm looking for, and you can route that groove all along here. And then when you get to the post, it's just as simple as drilling into the post with a hole. You're connecting the wires and you're just kind of logically going one light to the next and making any of your connections up underneath the deck wherever possible. So you want to try to keep those wires as concealed as you can. Up underneath the deck, you can use wire staples to go into the bottom of the joist or the ledger board. So there's multiple ways that you can hide it, but what you want to do is just understand that I put them in every post, by the way. So I try to go every single post because it's going to look a little odd if you start skipping posts. And one of the things that I'll show you is just kind of a little hack that we did in this corner. You can see how we did this as a 45 degree light. So where this corner, where we use these little blocks, you can see where this comes together as a 90 degree corner. We just made some 45 degree blocks on each side, which allowed us to mount this light straight on coming out. So that, you know, there's a couple little details and hacks that you can do to make this look great, but this is such a nice way to upgrade a deck or to finish it off. This encourages people when they look out the window at night to say like, yeah, that's a place that I wanna hang out. And it's easy because a lot of times people get together on their deck and they're placing lamps or they're turning on that one single, here, I'll show you right here, this one single light bulb on the outside of the house, and that just really doesn't cut it. I mean, it's one source of light, and then mosquitoes wanna circle around it in the summertime, and you're trying to create an area that an entire table full of people can enjoy. But this deck lighting provides nice even light throughout the whole deck. So if you have questions about this installation or installing your system, leave them in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe to this channel if you're learning something from it. Certainly we want to create value for all those who come here, and like this video if you like it. Have a great day. Thank you.